I've come to believe that diversity carves a path to greatness. That diversity comes in the form of climates, it comes in the form of plants and animals, and of course, it comes in the form of people. This is the Rainbow Nation. Home to 12 official languages and a multitude of religions and ethnicities. Where ancient mangrove forests and desert plains meet, weaving a vibrant tapestry for all to enjoy. From the echoes of history to the rhythm of modern cities, South Africa's welcoming spirit serves as a reminder that change is possible, and its impacts amplified when we embrace our differences. Here, we'll discover firsthand how technology and tradition combine to form cloud cultures. Beyond the shadow of apartheid, South Africa is on a mission to expand diversity across industries, working as a collective to bring a mosaic of perspectives, experiences, and talents together in the pursuit of progress, giving rise to a new generation of trailblazers in the process. It's a story too big and too rich to explore alone, though. So, to help me on my journey, I've reached out to my friend, Hluma Magodla, who recommended we meet on a very important street in Soweto.
Hey, Hluma.
Hey, Corey.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Yeah, this is great.
Welcome to South Africa.
Oh, thank you. And so this is Vilakazi Street.
It is Vilakazi Street.
So what is that? It's very popular.
It is. It is. This is the heart of Soweto. This is where former President Nelson Mandela and Desmond Tutu used to live. But now it's more where people come and have fun, very touristy, lots of culture.
Yeah.
Lots of people, as you can see.
It's really
but
great.
Also, most importantly, lots of culture for us to view to immerse yourself in.
Great.
Yeah.
All right.
Let me show you around.
I'd love to see
Let's
it.
Take a walk.
Let's go. Yeah. So, Hluma, tell me about your history.
So, I am originally from the Western Cape.
Okay.
But I obviously now work and live in Johannesburg.
Uh-huh.
My parents are from the Eastern Cape.
Okay.
And I am from the Xhosa tribe.
Okay.
That is where I'm from. Yeah.
Yeah.
Exciting language, exciting language.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that is originally where I am from. And growing up, I've always tried to ensure that I immerse myself in culture and
right.
diversities within the context of South Africa.
Uh-huh.
That's what I try and do. That's the joy of living in a country like this, right? Every day is something new to learn.
Every
a language, an experience, a culture, a tribe, something new every single day.
Just even the sights and the sounds, so much diversity. The indigenous tribes, languages, culture,
It's
unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's why I'm actually really excited about my two meetings.
Mm-hmm.
I'm meeting with Peace Parks, which focus on slightly different diversity, biodiversity, plants and animals, and maintaining a diversity of those. And then Lelapa AI, an AI startup, focusing on indigenous language preservation. It's going to be really cool.
It's going to be really cool. So while you're doing all of those exciting meetups, I'm going to be meeting up with YES, which is a foundation that focuses on upskilling unemployed youth, right?
Oh, so important.
We want to make sure that we get everybody on board in participating not only in this digital economy, but the South African economy.
And what's that over there?
Let's go take a look.
Yeah. If that was the beginning of this trip, I can't imagine it getting any better.
It gets better. Later on, I'm showing you some modern South African music.
I'm in.
If Vilakazi Street is any indication, the rhythm of tradition beats strong here in South Africa. I can already tell I'm going to learn a lot on this trip. Sometimes, though, in order to get a better perspective on something, it helps to trace back to its roots. In this case, 350 million years back. Which is what brings me to the Cradle of Humankind, an anthropological site home to the fossils of some of our oldest ancestors. Meeting me here are Jade Abbott and Mbali Ndandani, CTO and CCO of Lelapa AI,
awesome. Thank you.
Who are working on a more modern approach to preservation.
I'm really excited to see this museum, the Cradle of Humankind.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, very excited. But before we go in, I know a little bit about Lelapa AI, but I'd love to learn more.
We're a startup, an African startup, building language technology for Africa. And this is important because we've got over 1 billion people on the African continent,
wow,
where only so few actually speak English. But unfortunately, the world has been written in English. Our access to information on the internet, while being transformative to many people, is not actually benefiting large swaths of the world,
right,
because they're not actually speaking the language. What we do is we build the tools to enable digital engagement in one's home language.
That's so impressive. Cool. Well, let's go in.
Yeah, let's go.
Wow. Look at this. They're actually preserving human history, millions of years old. When you think about some of the work you guys are doing, how do you feel like it's similar?
So language represents more than just a means of communication. It represents entire ways of thinking. It represents philosophies. It represents culture. And if we lose a language, we lose all those aspects of it.
When you think about AI and the common usage cases people talk about, you know, customer service, supply chain. Why have you chosen this for where you'd focus AI scenarios?
Language really is the entry point. It is the access, enabling people who are currently excluded. And so language becomes a gateway that enables all the other things, supply chain, customer service, all of these other things to exist.
And when you think about South Africa, obviously the cradle of humankind, how has that influenced the work that you guys are doing here?
In South Africa, with its past, there's been a history of language being used as a tool for division. You know, the only way we can really move forward as a country is to be able to look at language and say, you know, how can we build those bridges?
So using language to connect versus divide.
Yeah.
There's something called appreciative inquiry in Gestalt theory, which basically says before you look around and say what's missing and what's lost, you look around and say what's beautiful here. And how beautiful and wonderful is it that in the heart of where humanity was formed, we're able to bring that back into the technologies as we chart forward what a future looks like where technology makes human lives better.
Wow, so it's from the beginning of mankind to making us all a little bit more human,
yeah,
using AI. In some of the work you're doing, you're using a holistically different approach to AI. What does that mean?
Many machine learning models that we know and that are very famous at the moment are largely based on publicly available pieces of art, pieces of work that have been, you know, created, and we're extracting them to make a model. The way we think about it is not an extractivism process, but rather a creative process. So we create our data from scratch. This is a side effect of not having any data out in the world, but it also means we can create a model with a certain intentionality. It also means that we're less likely to have bias and issues in the data because we intentionally helped create it for the place that it's actually meant to be in. And the models themselves that we work on are resource efficient. So instead of trying to get bigger and bigger and bigger, we see how small can we get.
Wow, what an amazing experience that was. What's next for Lelapa AI?
For us, it's really around enabling this capability and spreading it out. So we really want to enable the global South. We've been able to figure out how to create language models in the toughest context in Africa. Mm. And we know we have the capability to do that across the global South and enable the ecosystem there.
Well, I'm so impressed by the work you're doing and look forward to seeing the impact you're going to have on the entire world.
Thank you.
Thanks again. While we may share the same origin story, thanks to the work of Lelapa AI, future stories have a much better chance of including all voices. When it comes to writing your own future, there's an entire generation hard at work to do just that. Here in South Africa, youth unemployment is a growing issue, which is what Hluma is going to talk about with Youth Employment Service CEO Ravi Naidu at one of their neighborhood training hubs. This one in the township of Alexandria.
So talk to me, why Alex?
The Youth Employment Service is like a opportunities ladder for young people,
yeah,
to get jobs and build their careers or become entrepreneurs. But we wanted to have some hubs that were embedded in communities that are typically neglected, because let's put the ladder in there.
Yeah, and that's so amazing. And talk to me, why specifically focus on the youth?
When you talk about long-term and the future, it's synonymous with youth. So when the big corporates got together with the government, they created a thing called the Youth Employment Service.
Yeah.
Which is now a public-private partnership, but it's 100% funded by the private sector.
Yeah.
Which is unique. You've got to spend 12 months working full-time, and at the end of which the company knows you quite well.
Mm.
They want to take you,
yeah,
in. We've done 153,000 people.
Those numbers.
Through the program, working full time every month. Another 4,000 people come to the program fully funded by the private sector, and then they go on hopefully to exciting things.
Walk me through how technology has actually affected the way that you actually run Yes as an organization.
That's a good question, because actually we've had to use a lot more technology plus AI in the office to do the work. Last year we did 982 programs. That means 982 corporates funded their own programs through us. Each gets a report.
Yes.
Each needs to know from a diagnostic point of view what happened, you know, what was the performance. In 2020, I think a report for a corporate would have taken us 2 weeks of slog times many hundred reports. Today, we can generate that same report in about 2 minutes. So it's really dramatically improved the productivity in turn just through the use of technology. Yeah.
Given your significant footprint with your different hubs around the country, how important is diversity within your student body?
To build diversity, it's really about getting people who otherwise wouldn't get the chance, and of course, women in particular.
Yes.
So what we find is 58% of all the Yes alumni are women. And then we find, from an income point of view, about 60% of them are coming from households which are dependent on social grants. So this becomes a very important opportunity for them to get beyond that status. It really is helping from a private sector environment to get a much more blended from a socioeconomic background. Mm-hmm. Because a country like South Africa, diverse works through being integrated and people not living in bubbles.
Thank you, Ravi. Thank you for meeting me.
Pleasure.
Thank you for the conversation.
In a country that's rebuilding its economy from the ground up, Yes is dedicated to making lasting change through their programs and creating the next generation of innovators here in South Africa while they're at it. Meanwhile, I'm on my way out of the city and into the Dino Kang Game Reserve, where I hope to see some of Africa's big five animals. And more importantly, to learn about the Peace Parks Foundation's plans to bring nations together
while tackling underemployment through nature.
Hey guys.
Good day.
Hello, Corey.
Good to see you, Brad.
Yeah,
how are you?
Welcome. Welcome.
Yeah, Wayne, good to see you. Thank you for having me here at Dino Kang. This is great. I know it's not your park, but it's very similar in concept to what you guys do with Peace Parks.
We deal with big national parks, quite significant in size, but the work that they do here, you know, it's equally important.
So what do you do at Peace Parks?
So we're involved in transfrontier conservation areas, and this is the management of large ecosystems that stretch across international boundaries, international borders.
Would you like to go for a game drive?
I'd love to. Let's check it out. There are no seat belts, so...
Hold tight. Hold tight.
Rock and roll. Yeah, what does the biodiversity sort of mean when it comes to specific animals that you can then attract here?
By bringing in certain species, it allows for the introduction of other key species. By creating biodiversity, it brings additional animals in, which fill the spaces that are missing.
There's a couple of rhinos sleeping in the back there.
Oh yeah, there they are.
Maybe you can back up for us?
Yeah. Wow, really beautiful.
So in some of our major parks where we've got quite significant rhino populations, we've had to deploy all kinds of measures to aid those parks in the protection of rhino.
And technology plays a pretty big role in those types of
Correct.
Protections, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
It spans from us being able to identify threats using AI with image recognition, right through to us be able to track where they're going to be, what influences their movement, and what factors we should be looking at to counter the threat.
You've got to deal with the security of rhino, but we've had quite a positive approach to rhino conservation.
Right.
In one of the parks that we work, which is Zanavo National Park in Mozambique, we've been proactively reintroducing rhino in partnership with the Mozambique government, which is perhaps the first rhino in that part of the world for more than 30 years.
Wow.
And it was a lot of work had to be done to make sure that we can protect and conserve these animals.
Right. Talk about an amazing usage of AI. The final product
is a baby rhino.
That's fantastic.
And it's all about showcasing that there's more value to the species than its horn.
Yeah.
If you can introduce key species, that brings visitors to a park. The more visitors you get into a park, the more benefits you can extend to the local people.
Yeah.
Becoming direct beneficiaries of the conservation effort.
That's fantastic. Well, this has been great. Looks like they're maybe in an afternoon slumber. Should we go see if we can find some other animals? There we go. There's some giraffes looking right at us.
We call them the models of the bush.
Oh, yeah?
They walk so elegantly.
They've got a beautiful gait.
Yes, they do. Yeah.
What kind of challenges do you have with technology and animals coexisting?
You do not have the neat and very well organized areas that you have in corporate.
Yeah.
We had a scenario where one of the satellite receivers was investigated by an elephant and then subsequently destroyed.
The elephant didn't like what he investigated.
And it led to an interesting conversation with the vendor. So we still have to work out how we get technology to coexist with the animal population.
So what's next? I mean, when you guys think to the future, where is this all going?
I mean, the protection of these ecosystems, these landscapes, is so vitally important. I mean, it helps sustain life on Earth when you connect all the dots.
Yeah, pretty big deal.
What we know is that, you know, traditional management of these protected areas is not going to achieve the end goal.
Right.
And that opens the door for approaches like integrated co-management.
Yeah.
It brings about shared responsibility and ownership for the protected area, helping us achieve our goal of conservation at scale and conservation that benefits communities and harmony between humans and animals. Not just in South Africa.
All of Africa and then all over the world. So let's get going and I'll see if I can capture any pictures of any really exciting animals.
I'm calling my first safari experience a success. Not only because of the animal sightings, but also because it's opened my eyes to the ways cloud and AI technologies can empower organizations like Peace Parks in their work of saving species, improving biodiversity, and uplifting local communities. After that enlightening adventure, I'm headed back to the city to catch up with Hluma. She's invited me to a local nightclub to experience the more modern, youthful sounds of South Africa's future. Good thing I packed some new dance moves for the trip.
I really like this music.
I told you I was going to bring you to a cool spot, right?
Oh, yeah.
So the sound you're listening to now is Amapiano.
Amapiano,
so
okay.
So it's for the young people and by the young people, but also to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Different sounds from different parts of South Africa coming together to make this unique sound that has taken over the world.
I love it. It just brings so many different sounds together. It's
precisely.
Really wonderful. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that diversity that is in this music, I continue to hear from all the folks we talked with. The folks at Lelapa AI.
Yeah.
And the preserving of indigenous language and
precisely.
Then of course preserving animals and plants with the biodiversity at Peace Parks. It was just really wonderful to see how that technology could enable the preservation of diversity.
Exactly. And I think the same applies to the Yes Foundation, right? All the work they're doing to ensuring that the youth is also part and parcel of this diverse and ever-booming world we're living in, making sure they're skilled for the future and able to participate. Lots to happen for South Africa.
Yeah.
Lots of ways that we can challenge the way in which technology is landing in our country, but also bringing new ways in which we can be applying this AI journey that we're on right now.
Yeah, so again, diversity applied with AI.
Precisely.
Well, looks like music's pumping.
It's
we should probably
party.
Get going.
Let's get going.
Let's go dance.
Alrighty.
All right.
Here in South Africa, progress is a delicate dance between innovation and preservation. By nurturing its range of existing cultures and ecosystems, the innovators of this country are forging a path to collective success. Its cloud culture is working hard to embrace change in a way that helps move everyone ahead, creating the tools, the technology, and rhythm an entire nation can move to. I've learned so much during my time here, but right now, I've got a plane to catch. Join us to explore how technology and culture intersect on the next episode of Cloud Cultures.